Hi, good evening, everybody. Understand you guys had a wonderful day. All day you would have got a lot of education from here and lot of insights about the industry as a whole. So what are we going to cover now? My agenda is very swift, straightforward, and just like basic high-level points. We are going to go through power of internet and how India has adopted from the enterprise segment, consumer segment, and also from the SME segment. We cover like online services, so where the global adoption is and how the local adoption is happening at the moment. And then we talk a little bit about Tucows, who we are. Hello, yeah. All right, quickly on the enterprise segment. Now, we all know IT and ITS services have become the backbone of Indian economy. All started 20 years ago, but predominantly we have been supporting and helping the global enterprises with our English language, human resources skills, and the IT services. So today, India has like 50% of India's income, $150 billion, comes from like IT and ITS services. Consumer segment, this is very interesting. I think how many of you would have actually gone through like railway ticket booking before 2003, too, like when it was all through the queues and there was no irctc.co.in? Can you just put your hands up? Wow. Imagine 2 hours in queues and now you can get your tickets in 2 minutes. What a wonderful change this internet has brought to our lives. Right from email, postman, the new generation will never even think like how we all used to wait for a postal letters coming from our family. And definitely today, the utility bills, etc., it's all like a push of a button. And in fact, now it's all with mobile. All we want to do is just we get our mobiles out, we search, oh, network is there, and yes, we can get the results out. Telecom. How many of you would have experienced like more than 100, 150 rupees paying for a minute for an international call? Wow, not too many, but yeah, it's growing. Oh, okay. And how much do we pay now? Zero. Wonderful. Yeah, so a day before yesterday, I had a call with my friend in Australia and I just wanted to take 30 seconds on a WhatsApp, clear voice and no cost whatsoever. So e-commerce, 2014 onwards, who would have imagined that every gully of India, you can have the delivered, not like, imagine the remote areas of India, whether it's Sikkim or like Uttarakhand, all products get delivered. So many benefits. However, friends, our SME segment hasn't benefited that much from the internet and internet-related services. We all complained about pricing. I have a slide which will actually give you a good understanding like how international small businesses, even though they do like $100,000 turnover in a year, and how they brand themselves. Whereas like we here in the country, we do millions of dollars of transaction, but we still don't spend much. Well, it all starts with the name in the world of internet for small businesses. Now, today we have like hundreds of extensions to choose from. So we have legacy domains, we have country code, and now we have like all the new GTLDs on the floor as well. So when we say it all starts with the name, so domain name is actually a key to the world of internet. You get a domain name registration done, build a website. Very importantly, to get your customer hooked to you for many, many years, this is the next new big thing the research has found, that every domain with an email is going to be the next way within the country. So we know there is like a website and the power of website. But then a lot of businesses will redirect to their social pages or whatsoever. However, email is something which is now going to grow heaps and bounds. So This is very important. Just have a quick look at it. All day you would have listened so many things like India is this, India is that. The next billion people are coming to come from India in the online world, and it's a huge market potential. However, even today, it's actually a push versus pull market. Not many small businesses come to you even today and ask for all the services, whether they want websites or their digital marketing services, blah, blah, blah. We are all pushing. Whether it's corporate or government, we are all pushing. So it's actually a push market. Saying that, next 5 years with the infrastructure development, this is now going to change. The next 5 years will actually open up whether India actually adopts the web, the impact from the web and domain industry. Next 5 years are very crucial, and that's one of the reasons all the global players, they are pretty much very optimistic about India. This is the slide like I really love so much, and I'd like to spend some time. This is a theme. So this is where the global industry stands from small to medium businesses, and this is where we stand today. Globally, approximately 340 million domains. Can anybody tell where are these domains coming from, or how many businesses would have registered these 340 million domains? Any ideas? Anybody? Okay, what happens in the West is like every business, as I already told you, even if it's $100,000, they might have 5 or 6 domains. They go for the GTLDs like Comnets, etc. Then they go for their CCTLDs, and now they are also actually acquiring their category-based domains. So they are very much conscious about the brand. Whereas in India, where we have 45 million businesses, it's only 5.5 million. And with a growth rate of mere around 10% year on year. And we also have a lot of dropouts. So globally, around 140 million websites. Now, this actually stacks 140 million websites and 340 million. So most of them have more than 2 domains. India, still we are at 2 million. So, but saying that, India has 500 million plus internet users, so second largest, which is only to China. That's one of the reasons all the businesses are so optimistic that India will actually go ahead with these services. And we are seeing, the trends are showing us that gradually there's an increase. Another big important point is proactive activity. So small businesses in the West, they actually register domains when they even think about a business. So they want to go into a mattress sales business or whether it's a real estate business, they will actually go and register and find if the domains are available. Accordingly, they'll do their business registrations. So they are so very proactive. Whereas here, we have very much a reactive approach. There was a recent study conducted by a major search engine, and they pretty much concluded that today, India should have 10 million plus websites online, whereas we only have around 2 million. So definitely opportunity is there, but there are associated challenges with it as well. In the developed market, now that they have basic things done, now they are actually rapidly changing. They are investing more on the technology. So recently in India, we would have seen a lot of retailers complaining about like marketplace taking their business online. But one thing to realize for them is it's a change in the business and the new generation, how they are purchasing their products. So global organizations, they are actually putting more and more investments in their shop. We call it the store. And they are getting it very much localized. So they are not leaving a single corner. And they are investing on their online shop and services better than the real ones. Saying that, this is good for India. There is rapid activity. So there's digital India. So previously, it was only the corporates who were doing the push. But with digital India, now lots and lots of government is also pushing in on it. So what are the points, like how you can grow in this business? Though these are points, and my friends, all you might know about it, but one thing about this is the fittest will survive. It's getting competitive, margins are going down, and if you have volumes, you will survive and grow. So there's a threshold. Once you cross the threshold, you start actually putting numbers on top of it. So for your customers, you need to show them the best names. So whether it's legacy, TLDs, CCTLDs, and new GTLDs, imagine like a business, ajayengineeringcompany.com, or say not available, and they just need ajayengineering.online, which is available. Yeah, that's a good option for the business. Definitely simple website packages, industry-specific templates, like chartered accountants. We have seen they have like a very much focused templates, whether it's doctors or everybody, they want to go digital. With such a massive change in the connectivity in the country and everybody going mobile, even in general discussions, you talk to your friends or anybody, and it's of any point, they'll just get the mobile out, search what is available, and within 5 minutes, they'll give you the review, whether this is right or this is wrong. So you need to be there. If you're not there, so we are losing significantly. So definitely there should be services which are actually not only to the website, but also to the profiles, directories, aggregators, etc. The ecosystem will include everybody, not only the aggregators and only the websites. It's a combination of everything. This is important. If you actually prepare and do some research on custom offerings with an integrated service or app, it happens to be very sticky. In fact, if you have like email, it's basic and most sticky services for very long term. So if you want a customer, you're selling it not very expensive in the first year and you want to make money from them in the many, many years, give them a product which is very, very sticky. And that can sustain for many years. A little bit about us, what we are, who we are, where we are coming from. We are world's few accredited registered ICANN, and we got this accreditation in late 1990s. Today, we are world's largest wholesale domain registrar, 30 million plus domains under management. We are reseller only focused, so we don't go direct. We are not consumer facing at all. Reseller neutral, so we pretty much, unless until it's a compliance issue, all our customers are actually resellers and their customers are their customers. We are based, headquartered in Toronto, Canada. We are connected to pretty much all the registries, GTLDs, new GTLDs, and all the CCTLDs. 670 plus is what we claim at the moment. We have a 24/7 support, network monitoring, and reporting. There has been instances that all systems face some or the other outages, and we do face outages as well, but our team is so strong that we find, investigate, report it all the time. So services, we have domain registration, as I told, 670 extensions. We have com, net, in, cloud, email today. We have a wide choice of GTLDs, CCTLDs, SSL certificates. I'm not sure everybody knows here, but we are one of the largest in the SSL offering globally. We have 70 plus options with all the providers. Hosted private labeled email. This we are calling like India mein sabse sasta sabse acha. So it's a business grade email at very economical, but it's purely email and nothing else. So a few integration solutions we provide. So there's an API for all our services, which is domains, SSL, email, API integration, WordPress, third-party integrations with Odin, etc. Now to conclude, we all understand the potential is huge. However, as I told, you need to be fittest to survive in the industry first, and then take it from there, and numbers are the thing that count. So globally, internet is used in a way, and we need to use it in a similar way. We do change according to our circumstances, and India is very unique for it, but we still try and manage to use the same way. So new ways of doing business, including identifying verticals, this is like very important. So a lot of businesses, like from small villages who were not able to sell their products previously, are now selling online. So there are a lot of case studies in this. So you have to target, like business mail, as I was telling, is one of the wonderful products that you combine it with the domain names, and it gives them a branded communication tool as well. Aggregators, it's actually a business opportunity and not a threat. Thank you. We are at booth 6. If anybody has any questions, we are welcome to ask now, or we can do it at the booth. Thank you.